is the direction, of course, of Kuwait and Iraq. Now, it's possible they could be redeploying. More likely, they've still got some work to do up there. It has been somewhat sporadic, maybe 20, 25 planes over the course of the past hour, but they are still lifting off after they have refueled and likely they have rearmed. It is not nearly the rolling thunder that we saw and heard early this morning about 3 a.m. when it all began, not nearly the kind of tension that we had around here at this hotel where the media is based. There were, as you have mentioned earlier in the broadcast, some air raid warnings. This shows you one of them. In fact, the first one, people were rushed out of their rooms as they had been working, put on gas masks and moved on down to the basement, which has been set up as an air raid shelter. There were two of those warnings. Both of them turned out to be false. At one point, they said maybe there was as many as five Scud missiles that had been thrown toward this eastern Saudi Arabian city where we're based, but that has all turned out to be false. Right now, it's one of the ironies of war that people find a way to go about their normal lives no matter what is taking place. Mark Litke has gone out and around the town, ABC News correspondent Mark Litke, to see how this community is responding to the new reality of war. Here's his report.
From the early hours of the attack, Saudi Arabian TV broadcast these very nationalistic and militaristic videos called the Songs of War. But dawn broke over a surprisingly calm Saudi Arabia. This is the city of Dhahran, a city always worried because it was within the range of Iraqi aircraft and missiles. The quiet streets this morning were patrolled by police cars, but all appeared normal. We talked to some paramilitary police who were confident that the city was safe now from the possibility of an Iraqi attack.
We don't see anything wrong. Everything okay.
Many shops here are still closed. Clearly, some Saudis choosing to stay at home a little longer. The most activity was at this Bank of International phone booths, mostly foreign workers calling home to reassure their families that they were safe.
Who are you calling?
My wife.
Yes. Where?
In Philippines. Because she's very worried about here in Saudi, this situation about the gold. Now that the war in Saudi is declared by President Bush.
In some ways, the city seems much more relaxed this morning, much less tense, as if the people here are relieved that the long waiting for something to happen has finally ended.
Well, you'll notice, Ted, that we refer to this as a town in eastern Saudi Arabia. We don't actually say the name. That's because of strict media regulations. We are not permitted to actually identify it, though I suspect there are an awful lot of people who know where we are, and certainly the Iraqis have some sense of where we may be, but we're following those rules.
Yeah, I was going to ask you, Forrest, the degree to which, I mean, what we're getting so far, and obviously in these early hours of the operation, we're hungry for any piece of video that we can get, but what we're getting is pool video of planes, aircraft being prepared, and we saw some a few minutes ago, daylight video. I assume that was shot this morning. But what kind of briefings are you correspondents getting over there, and from whom?
Well, right now, the only briefings that are coming out in Riyadh and from the Pentagon. Here in Dhahran, it is deathly still. This is really a deployment area. The media pools have gone out, and most of the media minders, as they are called, have gone out with them. There's not much you're going to find around here now, just a little security, and that's all. We haven't gotten a single briefing at this point. We've been getting what information we can from Riyadh and from telephone conversations, and of course from listening to you.
There is late word that has just come in from both the British and the Saudis that all of their aircraft, and of course there were four nations that were involved in these air attacks on Iraq and Kuwait, the four nations being, of course, the United States, Great Britain, Saudi Arabia, and there were even a few Kuwaiti aircraft. We have not yet heard from the Kuwaitis, and curiously enough, not yet heard from the United States in terms of any formal announcement that all of the aircraft are back safely. There have been suggestions that they're all back safely, but both the Saudis and the British are claiming that all of their missions were successfully completed and that the aircraft made it back without any loss of life or aircraft. What else can you add, Forrest?
Well, I want to add one caution, Ted. As you've been looking at this pool video that's been coming in, it really is the obvious. You know that the pools are taken to those locations where the military permits. They are seeing only those things that the military is showing them, and those pictures reflect that. This is, in that sense, a very controlled kind of picture that we're able to give to you at this point, and I think we ought to take it with that kind of grain of salt.
Forrest Sawyer, thank you very much. We're going to take a short break so that our stations can identify themselves, and we'll be back with further coverage of Operation Desert Storm.
Right now, we're all concerned with the outbreak of war in the Gulf. Monitoring the world 24 hours a day. Stay with the experience of ABC News.